चंद्रम यजतम विश्वधायसम दमूनसम गृहपतिम वरेण्यम त्वामग्ने अतिथिम पूर्व्यम विशः शूचिष्केशम गृहपतिम निषेदिरे बृहत् केतुम पुरुरूपम धनस्पृतम सुशरमाणं स्ववसं जरद्विषं त्वामग्ने मानुषीरीरते विशोहोत्राविदं विविचिमिरत्नधातमं गुहासंतं सुभगविश्वदर्शतं त्वेश्वनसं सुययं कृतश्रियम्
Book The Mother from the Collective Works of Sri Aurobindo, Volume 32, page 479, Topic Relation Between the Mother and Her Children, Subtopic The Mother's Love. Sri Aurobindo says, there is no need to ask for pardon, for the mother has not in the least been angry or displeased with you. You may be sure of her love always. Question: no more shall I seek signs of the mother's love in an outward way. What difference does it make if she touches me a little or more or does not touch me at all? If the love is received properly within, that alone is the true thing. If it is not received or if it is diffused or dispersed or misdirected after receiving it, that is like throwing pearls before swine. For the Sri Aurobindo says, yes, that is the truth and it is the attitude every sadhak should take. Question: we all want mother's love, but I wonder how many of us truly love the mother. Where indeed do we see one-pointed, ever-sacrificing, never-failing love? Who has love only for the divine? For the Sri Aurobindo says, it does not mean that there is no love, but the love is mixed up and covered with egoism, demand and vital moments. At least this is the case with many. There are some, of course, who have no love at all, or love, if it can be called so, only for what they get. One or two are who love truly, but in a greater many there is a psychic spark hidden in much smoke. The smoke has to be got rid of so that the spark may have a chance of growing into a blaze. Sri Aurobindo says, do not think whether people agree with you or do not agree with you, or whether you are good or bad, but think only that the mother loves me and I am the mother's. If you base your life on that thought, everything will soon become easy. Sri Aurobindo says, it is because of the thoughts about others and your badness that you feel far from the mother. All the time she is very near to you and you to her. If you take the position I told you and make it the basis in your life, the mother loves me and I am hers, the curtain would soon disappear, for it is made up of these thoughts and nothing else. Question: the mother loves because she is love and cannot but love. Still, we feel that she cannot love as we do, and on one part we cannot bear the constancy and whiteness of her love. For the Sri Aurobindo says, obviously, if people expect the ordinary kind of love from the mother, they must get disappointed. The love based on the vital and its moods, but that is just the kind of love that has to be overpassed in yoga or transformed into something else. Sri Aurobindo says, certainly it is not necessary for you to become good in order that the mother give you her love. Her love is always there, and the imperfections of human nature do not count against that love. The only thing is that you must become aware of it always there. For that, it is necessary for the psychic to come in front, for the psychic knows, while the mind, vital and physical, look only at the surface appearances and misinterpret. Let me repeat this. Sri Aurobindo says it is necessary for the psychic to come in the front, for the psychic knows, while the mind, vital and physical, look only at the surface appearances and misinterpret them. It is that for which the mother's force is working. And whenever the psychic comes near the surface, you have felt love and nearness coming up. But it needs time to prepare the other parts so that they also may come, they also may know and feel. Therefore, the patience is necessary, and the confidence that through all the delays and difficulties of the sadhana, the mother is leading you and will surely lead you home to her. Sri Aurobindo continues to say, X is probably making two mistakes. First, expecting outward expressions of love from the mother. Second, looking for progress instead of concentrating on openness and surrender without demand of a return. These are the two mistakes which sadhaks are constantly making. If one opens, if one surrenders, then as soon as the nature is ready, progress will come of itself. But the personal concentration for progress brings difficulties and resistance and disappointment because the mind is not looking at things from the right angle. The mother has a special kindness for X, and every day at pranam she is trying to put a sustaining force upon him. He must learn to be quiet in the mind and vital and consecrate himself so that he may become conscious as well as receive. The divine love, unlike the human, is deep and vast and silent. One must become silent, one must become quiet and wide to be aware of it and reply to it. You must make it his whole object to be surrendered so that he may become a vessel, an instrument, leaving it to the divine wisdom and love to fulfill him with what is needed. Let him also fix this in the mind, not to insist that in a given time he must progress, develop, get realization and experience. Whatever time it takes, he must be prepared to wait and persevere and make his whole life an aspiration and opening for one thing, and that's only the divine. To give oneself is the secret of the sadhana, not to demand and acquire a thing. The more one gives oneself, the more the power to receive will grow. But for that, all impatience and revolt must go. All suggestions of not getting, not being helped, not being loved, of going away or abandoning life or the spiritual endeavor must be rejected. Sri Aurobindo says, as for the feelings about the mother and that her love is only given for a return in work or those who can do sadhana, well, that is the usual senseless idea of the vital physical mind and has no value. Sri Aurobindo says, it is not mother who makes you cry. It is the forces from the vital nature that make you sorrowful and think of dying and of the past. What comes from the mother is just love and light and peace and joy and the spiritual life of the future. Never mind about the purity of the body. The love of the mother purifies your heart, both your heart and your body. If the soul's aspiration is there, the body also is pure. What happened in the past does not in the least matter. These are the words of our Lord Sri Aurobindo.